Joining us all the way from hashtag South Africa, it's our superstar Desmate Lizard! Oh, we missed you, and we loved watching you night after night. It was a privilege, and Australia finally... I mean, they came on board, didn't they? Congratulations. We were always voting for you as our favourite project host in the jungle. I want everyone to know that. How did it feel to sit on that throne after four torturous weeks?
It was so surreal. The best part is the throne was quite soft, whereas down in camp, everything was hard, so all our butts were a bit sore. So to sit on a nice soft surface was lovely. But it felt really surreal because we had no idea how we were being received at home, we had no idea what was going to air, whether people liked us. I was just worried about whether I was embarrassing my kids and my husband or not. But it was just amazing to get to that point and to share the last 3 days with Aisha Scott and Harry Garside was such a joy because they are the best people. So I've just had the best month of my life.
Last night you had the nation in tears when you were reunited with your family. What was that like? What did it feel like for you?
Well, I got tricked into thinking that I had to sit in the camp and wait for Tim from publicity to come and have a chat to me. And I was sitting there just looking around and then suddenly I hear, "Mum." And I looked around and it was my kids who I had missed so much. I'm starting to cry again. And, like, they were in the camp, for real. They weren't just in my dreams. And often at night I'd have a little cry because I missed them and Matthew so much. So when I saw them, we were all so lost for words. And to just see them and kiss them and smell them. And then 30 seconds later, Matthew walked through the door and to hug him. And he was shaking so... We just all missed each other so much, and that was just one of the greatest moments because we were together again as a family, and you know that's my family is the most important thing in my life. So I just loved seeing them, and I even loved their little trick when they came in and surprised me.
Well, I was going to ask about that because they were happy to see you at first, but then they were delighted to unleash pain on their mother who they had not seen in a while. Will you be having words later?
Didn't take them long to turn, did it? It was just a matter of hours and they were gone. Anyway, they're grounded for the rest of their life and I've drafted letters to Santa Claus, the Easter Bunny and the Tooth Fairy. I'll be speaking to their school about lunchtime detentions until they're 20. So, yeah, there will be repercussions.
You know what? We loved you. I mean, everyone who came out of the jungle was just Team Liz. In fact, people are saying that you need to go into politics now.
Oh, no, I'm above politics, actually. I'm really into royalty. I'm not a Republican, but now that I'm Queen Liz, I think I'll just stick with this. No, look, I got asked about it while we were in the jungle. Dicko put me on the spot. And to be honest, my priorities are my family and I wouldn't do anything like going into politics until my kids are much older and they've finished school. So that's really a question for another decade.
In the meantime,
I'm just going to come and hang out with you guys if you'll have me back.
It's not. And now we have to read everything you say between the lines, Liz, don't we?
You do. You're very good at that, though, Waleed. You'll be fine.
Well, you ultimately won. That's all that matters in the end. But $100,000 is the prize. Donate to you, to your charity of choice, Share the Dignity. Tell us about how important that charity is for you.
Oh, look, I think Share the Dignity is so important because they provide much-needed period products to women who are fleeing domestic violence, who are homeless, who are struggling to make ends meet. And with the rising cost of living, demand on this particular charity is greater than ever. But they provide sanitary packs to women who need them through 3,000 charities across Australia. They lobbied the government to remove the luxury tax on period products, and now they're lobbying to make sure that period products are available for free for women in public hospitals. So it's one of those things we don't talk about enough. You know, periods are something that affect 50% of the adult population for 25% of their lives. And if women can't access these products to help them be dignified, it affects their family, it affects their life. So Share the Dignity really does hand people back their dignity in these really trying moments. So I'm really proud to be able to say that, you know, $100,000 is going to them. They've got plans on making sure they continue to stock their dignity vending machines so that women can access these products without having to ask or beg. So I just love the work they do.
It's such a great cause. It's so well said. But my favourite thing about what you just said is that you spoke for a while about dignity wearing that on your head.
I forgot I've got a crown on my head.
Congratulations. You should be so proud of yourself. Good luck getting that crown home through customs.
Yeah, thank you. I think I've got a fight with Border Force coming my way, but, you know, I've never met anyone that I didn't want to have an argument with, so we'll see how we go.
Thanks, mate.
Love you, Liz. Bye.
Thanks, guys. Love you too.